The kidnapping of students in Nigeria by terrorists remains a topic of interest as it brings to light the state of insecurity in the country. It basically sends a clear message that no one is safe. It is disheartening that school children are mostly targeted by the perpetrators of these violent crimes. According to Karl Marx, history keeps repeating itself. First, as a tragedy because it is an incident that shouldn't have occurred. Then, as a farce because we fail to learn from our past mistakes. That is the situation in which we, the citizens of Nigeria, have found ourselves in. The abduction of Chibok girls on April 14, 2014 served as a red flag because it showed the need for the country's borders to be strengthened. Here, 276 female students of government secondary school Chibok in Borno State were whisked away and taken into captivity by Boko Haram insurgents. The girls were led into Sambisa Forest. Although some were rescued, over 100 girls are still missing. After almost 4 years, another abduction of female schoolgirls occurred in neighboring Yobe State on Monday, February 19, 2018, at exactly 5:30 p.m. About 110 female students of Government Girls Science Technical College, DAPCHI, between the ages of 11 and 19 years old, suffered the same predicament as they suddenly disappeared without a trace. Boko Haram terrorists once again claimed responsibility for the kidnap. However, in March of the same year, the government claimed that the girls had been freed. While the country was still trying to recover, hundreds of gunmen riding on motorbikes raided a boarding school in Kankara, Katsina State and seized more than 300 schoolboys on the 11th of December 2020. The boys were also taken into Rugu Forest. However, some of the schoolboys were able to scale the fence and run for their dear lives when they heard the gunshots that night. To make matters worse, the tragic event happened on the same day Nigeria's president, Muhammadu Buhari, traveled to the state for the festive period. The schoolboys were released days after negotiations between the government and kidnappers. One of the freed boys explained their harrowing experience to BBC, saying that they were subjected to harsh conditions as they were beaten and forced to work barefooted throughout the night. 8 days later, a fresh attack happened in Mahuta village, Dandume local government area of Katsina State. Armed men reportedly kidnapped at least 80 school children while they were returning home after participating in a religious ceremony. Police later revealed that the victims were rescued. Nigerians can only hope that the spat of kidnapping in the country is brought to the barest minimal. Let us know what you think in the comment section below. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and check out our channel for more interesting videos. Thanks for watching and see you on our next video.